I'm up 125 feet from the Met stage in the domes, where one of the most difficult feats in show business takes place every day. I'm with first assistant electrician Tim Guscott, who oversees the follow spot operators who are working their magic in today's performance. Hello, Tim.
Hi, Eric.
So here's some footage of you in action during an earlier part of the opera.
Touch more in a Domino. Nice. Come way down on Ilya.
Lights 49. Go.
Try dipping to a high glow on Ilya. Hold there. Come up on Ilya now, way up on Ilya.
So this is the domes. Could you explain a bit to our audience what that name means and what happens up here?
Absolutely. The architects chose to make some circular impressions in the roof, or rather the ceiling of the auditorium. And people who are sitting in the orchestra can look straight up and see that the main chandelier hangs from a dome-shaped impression. So when we look down from up here, that's what we see.
Okay. And how many follow spot operators are up here today, and where are they positioned?
Today we have 6 total. We have 3 in this booth and 3 in the booth that's behind you. The booth that's a little bit farther back has a better chance of getting underneath the header for singers who are further upstage.
Okay. And since the Met is the largest opera house in the world, I imagine the Met has also the longest throw of any theater. What's the distance from here to the furthest point on stage that you have to light?
I imagine it's about 150 feet.
Wow, that's amazing. And so can you show me how this spotlight works?
Absolutely. This lever is called the dowser, and it makes the intensity of the light brighter or dimmer. This lever is called the iris, and it works just like the iris in your eye. There's a little thing that gets larger and smaller so that we can either get an artist's head or include their whole costume. These levers put color filters in the line of the light, so we can use amber filters for a daytime scene, for example, and a bluer color for a nighttime scene.
So what kind of skills do you need to work a follow spot operator at a Met, especially, I mean, these quarters are so tight?
Well, I would say someone who got a U in works and plays well with others is probably not a good candidate, because we spend an inordinate amount of time in this very small room together. However, it's simple to teach a person how to operate this equipment. What's more difficult is that they be able to see the stage picture in their mind's eye and correctly imagine what part they're going to play in it. So we've had some operators here with very, very high skill levels that couldn't see what they should be doing in terms of how fast they pick up, how fast they go out, what their intensity should be compared to everyone else.
Now, are there extra challenges when a show is being transmitted live in HD?
Yes. I think that the HD cameras don't see light in exactly the same way that the human eye does. So, for example, if 2 singers are standing next to each other on stage, there could be a minor discrepancy in the balance of their intensity that the audience wouldn't see and that we can't necessarily perceive. It's our good fortune to have a lighting designer in the truck who's watching the feed, and sometimes when we make a correction, it's imperceptible to us and the house audience. But obviously it makes a huge difference in the transmission.
Now, this season, has there been a production that has been particularly challenging to light?
It's funny you should ask, because the one that jumps right to mind is Robert Lepage's L'Amour de Loin. You and I both are very well aware that Act 2 opens with Jaufre and the Pilgrim entering on the boat and then laying down to sleep for the mermaid sequence. And the lighting designer asked us to light Jaufre's face perfectly without hitting the boat.
Wow.
Which is challenging.
Right.
But also our automation department, which is amazing, was able to make the boat move continuously back and forth. So not only did we have to stay on the face of Jaufre and off the boat, and we had to continuously move just a tiny bit.
Yeah.
So that was a challenge.
I bet, especially with the LED lights on the stage itself.
Correct.
So you're lighting a lit stage.
Well, we were looking into the LED lights, which made it difficult to judge our intensity at certain points.
Yes. Well, thank you so much, Tim, for joining us. And this is all quite fascinating, indeed. At the end of Act 2, Crete has been plunged into chaos as Idomeneo has confessed to breaking his oath. As the final act begins, he desperately searches for a way to save his son's life. Will the gods be appeased? I'll be playing a part in that decision. Although my duties as host are over, it will be my singing voice you'll hear when Neptune makes his final judgment. Here now is the conclusion of Idomeneo.
comando, fuggi il paterno lido e cerca altrove sicuro asilo.
Oh,
all'avenger tuo, immensa turba di popolo affolato ad alta voce, parlar ti chiede.
Qual che nuovo fanno, provate il mio cor.
Perduto è il figlio.
E il dio dei mari, il sommo sacerdote la guida.
È troppo disperato il caso, intesi arpace.
Quel nuovo disastro!
Strage orror lugubri aspetti. Ah, si non più non sei, se la città del pianto e questa reggia quella del dunque per noi dal cielo sbandito ogni che nome amico si placchi a tanto il sangue. Un nome solo basta tutti a piegar. Alla clemenza il rigor cederà. Ancor non scorga il calcimiri pietoso. Ah, sordo il cielo! Ah, sordo il cielo! Sua gloria sotto alte rovine. Sue miserie pria non avranno fine.
nobil regno, fai crudo mostro. Ammira alla carta di sangue quelle pubbliche figlie. Vedrai chi c'ama, all'alma gonfia d'atro velen, dal corpo è sana. Esclamas picotito, e da te l'aiuto implora. E andugi ancor! Al tempio, sire, al tempio! Qual è? Dov'è la vittima? Nettuno rendi quello che è suo,
non più sacro ministro per voi popoli.
Thank you. Suona qui intorno applauso di vittoria.
Sire, il trence gli levante l'eroe, di morte in traccia disperato correndo, il trionfo trovo. Sull'empio vostro scagliossi furibondo, vi vinse e uccise, eccoci salve al fin. Che vedo
un nome. scelta non è. Contro il figlio innocente, alzar la stravipende, da ogni fibra già si infuggon le forze, e gli occhi miei torbida notte ingorra.
Thank you. sacrificio e sciolto il vato. Nettuno e tutti i nomi a questo re resta chi al cenno loro in nomine
Oh, Christ! Okay.
And we're there. Thanks.
Well done. That's amazing. Alan.
Was it as awful as you remember?